Good morning and welcome to Hour of Grace, showing on Gospel of Hour. I remain Pastor Tony Etim, the General Overseer of Word of God and Thursday Ministries, located at 512 Toron Road by Faikoro Pabio, Mbiabong, Uyo, Akwa Ibom State. Before I kickstart today, I would like us to go to the Lord in prayers. Please may we bow our heads as we pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, as your word is being shed, let your word set the captives free. Let your word bless. Let your word transform lives in the precious name of Jesus. I vow to give all the glory to you, Lord, in Jesus' precious name. Today, I shall be sharing with you on what I titled, How to Renew Your Mind. Turn with me to the book of Romans chapter 12 and in verse 2. It says, "And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God." Notice the scripture never said our mind is being renewed by grace. According to Ephesians 2 and verse 5, we are saved by grace. When it comes to renewing of mind, we have a responsibility. We have a part to play. I give you an example. Something happened in Port Harcourt in the year 2010, precisely September, at a place called Garrison bus stop. A young lady was returning from market and it rained heavily that day. The gutters around our house were overflowed. And she wanted to cross over to her compound and mistakenly slipped into the gutter. She was there struggling and we rushed and rescued her, brought her out of the gutter, dirty, stinking and smelling. And after a while, we got her resuscitated. She thanked us and then walked away to her house. Now, when she was in the gutter struggling for life, God brought us to help her out. That could be likened to God saving her by grace. But after she was saved by grace, if you watch, she walked on her own back to her house, get herself cleaned up, refreshed, then wore a new dress. That could be likened to renewing of mind. One was God that did it by grace. Secondly, she had a responsibility. Imagine that girl, after we rescued her from gutter, now she decided to sit by the gutter and I begin to say, "Oh God, come and take me home. God, come and clean me up. God, come and beat me. God, come and change my clothes." She would have been there for almost God knows how long and maybe help would never have come. But incidentally, that's what Christians do. After we are born again, we expect God to do the rest for us. No, we have to get our mind renewed. That will come from our subconscious. We have to deal with that by ourselves. We have to study the word of God. We have to think the way God thinks. We have to renew our mind by constantly feeding on the word of God. When we feed on the word of God, we will now know what God is expected of us. Now, for instance, if we must renew our mind, there are factors we must consider. For instance, number one, we must let go of our old way of life. If you look at the book of Ephesians, let's turn to Ephesians chapter 4 and hear what God's word says. Ephesians chapter 4 and in verse 22, it says that ye put off concerning the former conversation the old man which is corrupt according to the deceitful lust. We have to consciously put off our old man. We have to do away with the old ways of life, do away with stealing, do away with corrupt practices, do away with bribery, do away with those things that does not give God glory. It takes our conscious effort and this takes a process of time. When a man is born again, his spirit is instantly recreated with the Spirit of God. That is instant salvation. Salvation is three phases. We have the instant, we have the continuous, and we have the final. Renewing our mind comes under the aspect of continuous. We have to constantly do this thing. We go to church, we hear teachings from God's word, we read anointed books, and that begins, by the time we begin to feed our subconscious with this new set of information from God's word, we discover that our life is now beginning to align with the way God actually wants us to live our life. If we look at 2 Corinthians 5 and verse 17, it says, "Therefore, if any man be in Christ, is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new." God is saying to you, the moment you are born again, your whole life should be done away with. Believe God. Let God be true and let all man be liar. Now, let me say this to you. If God says all things are possible, who are you to retain the old things you used to do? And the man talking to you right now, if I play my past on the television for you to watch, you will not want to listen to me. But God does not look at your past to determine your future. God looks at your willingness to serve him and grace is released to get the job done. God will not look at your past record. He's telling you here that all things have passed away. You better believe God. In fact, Christianity is that simple. Perhaps that's the reason people don't believe Christianity. How will someone say, all the bad things I've committed, all the sins I've committed, just by confessing Christ, I am saved? That's what God says. And that's how we say it is. If you go against it, you are not obeying God. Now, let me say this to you. If an armed robber, for instance, goes to church and gets convicted by the teaching of the pastor at the time and decides to give his life to Christ, instantly his spirit has been recreated with the spirit of God. He is born again. His spirit man is saved. But the act of armed robbery will have to be dealt with over time. How is he going to deal with that? He will now begin to study the word of God, listening to life transforming tapes, read books written by anointed men of God, and all of that. He keeps serving God and keep coming. After a while, he will begin to realize that most of the things he is doing are not in line with God's word. They begin to appreciate that this new set of knowledge he's receiving now is the one that will help him. After a while, you see the man begin to drop the idea of carrying gun. Before you know what's happening, he has dropped gun finally. Brethren, that is one way you could get your mind renewed, by dwelling on the word of God, created materials, anointed materials. I want to tell you, thank you for your time. Like I said earlier, I remember the 2018. I want to tell you, get your mind renewed. Focus on the word of God. Focus on things of God. I say this to you finally, it is not over until you become a soul winner. God bless you. And before I round up, I want to introduce this book to you. The name is How to Renew Your Mind After Salvation. This will keep you continuously saved. This will guarantee your salvation status and help you to stay pleasing God at all times. God bless you. It is well with you.